When this place looks like one moonscape, don't say it in one year. Money, money, money.
The way he plays football, often on the field, Harry Kane is an ultimate professional.
So when you saw Kane claim that goal last year off, was it Ericsson, his teammate?
Yeah.
And he got kind of, didn't he? It was really funny. Everyone
loves,
was like,
loves it.
He's going to roll over his granny to make sure he gets the goals. One of the things I think is this is Tottenham maybe pandering a bit to Kane. They have to be quite careful. Kane could leave Tottenham. He's not going to. For me, not at the moment. There's something quite good going on at Tottenham. But, you know, obviously they're in this position where there is a danger that at the end of the season, the kind of goodness that's happened is kind of disbanded. Now, I kind of feel like Kane might have said, I want to play whatever. But I look at Tottenham against Wolves and I think Tottenham are out on their feet and they've got a semi-final, a chance to go and get silverware before you even get a title run in. And they are arguably in the title race, even though they're not that heavily fancied. So why wouldn't you just say, hey, Harry, just relax.
If do you know what? I'll answer that.
He'd be murdered, wouldn't he?
Yeah. Can I answer that, Georgie, on that, right? I played up front with Teddy Sheringham, right? And there was a massive difference between us, right? I'd always be okay about most things. I would be, if someone claimed a goal and I thought, okay, don't worry.
Whatever.
Okay. He would claim everything. Do you know what? He outscored me every year. By a goal. On one particular year, he got one goal more than me. And I played really well that year. And he got one. And Teddy was in a fight with me to outscore me. That's how Teddy works, right? Now, if Harry Kane's got that in him, which he clearly has, to get every goal, claim every goal, and want to play every minute, that's telling you how hungry he is to be successful and be the very best. Okay. Isn't that what everyone had to go at Ronaldo? Ronaldo, one thing you can't ever aim at Ronaldo is that whatever he does, he's always trying to get one better
Ronaldo
than somebody else.
Ronaldo never looks tired. Harry Kane has, and that is my only kind of why.
Well, that's
last night.
That's down to I think you alluded to the Wolves game where a lot of people questioned. The Wolves game first half, Tottenham battered them. Okay, and in the second last 20 minutes, they've run out a little bit out of steam, but also Poch got the manager obviously sensed Wolves' counter attack style was a real problem for Spurs, and the game was changed in the last 20 minutes. Now, Harry, at times, look, he does play a lot of football, but I'm sure he's a good enough pro to, if the manager says, look, we've got a cup game this week, we've got this is what I want from you, and let's just chat and talk about it, because managers do talk to players. They do have a conversation about how do you feel, are you okay, well I didn't think you was sharp enough, as a like, you sure you want to, you know, they ask questions and then react to your response and then watch you in training, Georgie. They watch you to see, you know what, I might make the decision for him. So it's a real tough one,
has he? Because Harry will want to play whatever.
Yeah, well I think one thing I do know, that I think Harry has shown that he's a single-mindedness to be as good as he can, and that makes the team better.
One thing I also know is Pochettino occasionally gets it wrong. Very rarely, cool. Actually.
Georgie, tell me a person who doesn't get things wrong.
No, I know that, but when Pochettino gets it wrong, sometimes it is that it's a season defining game.
Yeah.
And it comes back to hurt them. Let's talk to Graham Beecroft, our Merseyside reporter. On poor old Tranmere. Morning, Beaky.
Good morning, Georgie. I've been listening to you make a mountain out of a molehill for the last 10 minutes, wondering when I'm going to get off.
It's not, but it's not a mountain out of a molehill, is it?
Absolutely, it's a mountain out of a molehill, yeah.
Because
we're talking about a player coming on for 15 minutes. I'll tell you now, Harry Kane, as Cass said, would have wanted to come on the field last night. Now, if Tranmere had been kicking Spurs players all over the pitch, then the Pochettino had every right to say, no, listen, I don't like it. There's a danger you're going to get hurt here. Tranmere had respect for the players last night. They didn't boot them up in the air. They didn't try and win a game or reduce the deficit that they were going to lose by kicking players up in the air. So, one, it was that sort of game. Two, he decided to give Harry Kane a run out. What would have happened at the end of that game there? I'll tell you, Harry Kane would have come on with any other unused substitutes, run up and down a pitch which wasn't, you know, the best in the world, let's be honest about it, for 15 minutes, and could have easily picked up a little knock, twisting his ankle, running up and down then. So it's better that he goes on the pitch, tries to get some goals, because Harry, as Cass said, would have wanted to score last night. He wants as many goals as he can get in the onion bag, and it's as simple as that.
Don't say it in one year. Money makes the trees come down. It makes mountains into molehills. Big money kicks the wire.